Aloha.
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 Sarang.
Sarang.
Okay, thank you. Revitalize it. Okay, love.
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 Okay, thank you. So, my name is Richard. I'm Denteh. I come from Ghana. And my supervisor, I am a student of Konkuk University. And my supervisor is Professor Konkuk. And I'm presenting on the topic maize production and natural science, organic and conventional. I want to just give a brief introduction of Ghana and the decision why I wanted to know about corn in natural farming. Now, so Ghana is about 24 million people and it employs about 55% of our population in Africa. And so you can see maize production is covering about more than a million hectares of land in Ghana. And you can imagine it's a very big deal when it comes to cereal production in Ghana. Actually, this research was carried out at Paju here in Korea. But we tried to do that and then replicate in Ghana based on the climatic and the conditions there in Ghana. So these are the main crops you can find in Ghana. Look at it, you see that maize is occurring as the second crop after cocoa. Ghana is popular for this cocoa followed by maize. Now rice has come up these days. Rice is becoming the dead after maize. So this gives you a clear understanding why I have decided to research so much into corn under natural farming for the purpose of our city today, natural farming. So yesterday I presented on this topic. So in order not to bore the majority who were here yesterday, I would like to make a skip of some of these points. But basically, looking around us and everything that is coming up, it is clear that conventional farming is a threat to our environment today. When we talk about food safety, we talk about environment, we talk about health, all you will see that conventional farming is having a factor to contribute. This is calling for a serious research into the established natural farming that Master Cho started here in Korea. The people of Hawaii are also doing very well. They are all over on YouTube and we are taking a lot of information from them. Mr. Eric, Mr. Trump, and so many others, we see them. We thank you for the good work you are doing. We are learning a lot from you, Hawaii people, and Philippines also. Thank you. So, I started my research in May, and then it ended in August. Maize, as I have said, and the variety I use is Chal Otsusu, and Ivory 2, that is a Korean developed variety. So we looked at corn under three farming systems: organic, natural, conventional. Let me see this. The natural, we use just natural, let me do this. Okay, we use just natural, resource materials, inputs, no chemical. the conventional, you know, fertilizer and the pesticides, which are now becoming the problem of the day. Well, you know, UN today say we are making a paradigm shift from, you know, Millennium Development Goal to what? Sustainable Development Goal. What it means is that we must look for better ways of what? Agriculture. So natural farming is all about, you know, maintaining a very good, you know, regime of nutrient cycle. So from seed, we did treatment to the seeds of natural farming, and then standards also were maintained for conventional and then organic, you know, likewise. Now, after our soil treatment, we came, you know, in with type 2. Most of us here, you know, are natural farming, you know, enthusiasts. So some of these things, we will not have to be explaining them anymore. The type 2 is what you come, you know, or the first input you will make after, you know, your soil treatment, which is IMO4, mineral, and then, you know, your mulch and other things. Now, this is foliar application. This one here, type 2, is foliar application to the crops. And this is supposed to give the whole crops a very good start in growth. Now, so transition here, also these are all natural soils, you know, very cheap to make, very cheap, very easy to apply, you know, resources. And this is supposed to help the crop to transform itself from, you know, the vegetative productive stage to the reproductive, you know, stage, where it starts to, you know, bear fruits and other flowers, other. Now, just after germination, not long after germination, there was some drought, and this is what happened to, you know, the crops. Look at this, this conventional is dying, wilting so much. But look at organic, look at conventional, almost everything is established. Now you can see a little bit of information we pick, counting by counting, and see natural 4, organic 3. You know, see conventional, 20 plants dying just because of short 1 week period of drought. Okay, so in the course of the group, we also recorded this. A lot of tillers. In the organic, there were a lot of tillers. Corn naturally is not supposed to, you know, tiller. It's supposed to be a single, you know, stem crop. But see, you have so many, you know, plants coming as suckers. See conventional, it's even more serious with conventional. But see the organic, you can go beyond 3 without, you know, tillers. And this tells you that we are not forcing the crop to perform as it stands as the law of what natural farming. Now there was insect occurrence. And look at it. From here, see, you see the leaves are all, you know, having those. It's also the same here. I know from there you cannot see very well, but it's not a very serious case here, but see that right, remains very clean. Very clean. And that tells you this, I want to say natural was able to stand because of the natural, you know, protective that was given to the crop, you know, from the inputs. They were all, you know, grown at the same, you know, place. How come insects came and they invaded other crops and then natural was left untouched? Now let's look at root development. See, so see natural. Look at the root size, very big and well developed, with a lot of root hairs, telling you that is going to make a very good thing from the soil. Now look at that of, you know, organic and conventional. This tells you how, you know, the what we call the outcome of growth is going to be. So let's now begin to look at the farmer's main, you know, goal into production, which is yield. So look at it. Ear length, ear width, you know, grain, you know, per plant. This is the farmer's, and look at the figures. See conventional, see natural, conventional, natural, conventional, natural. And let's look at number of seeds. Number of seeds per plant. See, this is conventional, and look at natural. Conventional, natural, conventional, natural. You know, this is grain weight at harvesting. You know, corn, when it dries on the farm, itself has some kind of moisture. So you take that weight, and then we took this weight after drying. And still, natural is still performing better than that of conventional. So this is the, you know, total outcome. Let's see. This is yield per ton, okay, per plant. And you can see the differences between conventional and natural. Conventional and natural. This tells you that, you know, natural farming is not only solving the problem of, you know, environmental health and then food safety issues, but also can contribute or can replace, can, you know, definitely replace, you know, other system, especially conventional, that is giving us all these problems in terms of food production. May I end here? Thank you.